बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामु अलैकुम। इट इज़ लेक्चर नंबर 6 ऑफ बेसिक स्टैटिस्टिक्स कोर्स। डेट कोर्स इज़ एसेंशियल फॉर ऑल दो स्टूडेंट्स हु वांट टू गेट द जॉब ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिकल ऑफिसर, स्टैटिस्टिशियन, सब्जेक्ट स्पेशलिस्ट, रिसर्च ऑफिसर और लेक्चरर ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम प्रोफेसर हसन एंड यू आर वॉचिंग माई चैनल Professor Hasan Humayun. Before starting today's precious lecture for you, I request everyone subscribe to my channel, like and share my channel, and click the bell icon for the notifications of the next videos. Let's start. Question number one is, if each value of the given data is decreased by 25%, what will be the change in arithmetic mean, geometric mean, हार्मोनिक मीन एंड मीडियन? दैट इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ वी हैव सम वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स 10, 20, 30, 40 एंड 50, दैट्स वी नो द मीन ऑफ दैट डाटा इज 30, एक्स बार इज 30, एंड इफ वी डिक्रीज 25%, 25% ऑफ 10 इज एक्चुअली 2.5, 10 माइनस 2.5 इज 7.5, 25% of 20 is 5, 20 minus 5 is 15, 25% of 30 is 7.5, 30 minus 7.5 is 22.5, 25% of 40 is 10, 40 minus 10 is 30, 25% of 50 is 12.5, 50 minus 12.5 is 37.5. The mean of the original data is 30. And the mean of that data, which is decreased by 25%, is 22.5. And you can see clearly that is the new mean, which is 25% decreased. And that rule is applicable for geometric mean, harmonic mean, and median as well. What did you learn? If all the values of x are decreased by some number, then arithmetic mean, geometric mean, harmonic mean and median will also be decreased by that specified number. Question number 2, if sum of 10 numbers is 200, sum of 10 numbers is 200, that is question number 2, summation x is 200, that is for 10 numbers. And by addition of two more numbers, the sum becomes 280. New sum is, which is summation x, 280. Find the two new numbers if the ratio between them is 1:4. A very important question. I want to discuss a basic point of statistics with you, a basic concept of mathematics with you. What is the meaning of ratio? 1:4 means if, let the first number is A, second number is B, first number is 1, second number is 4. If I multiply both numbers by 2, 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8. First number is 2, second number is 8. If you cancel, that will be the same, 1:4. If you multiply first number with 3, second with also 3, 3 ones are 3, and it is 4 threes are 12. Let the two numbers are 1x and 4x. If in the paper some ratio is given, you will have to suppose, if for example you have ratio is 2:3, then the two numbers will be 2x and 3x. In that question, ratio was 1:4. I supposed the two numbers are 1x and 4x. Now the sum of these two new numbers will be, you can see clearly, the previous sum was 200 and the new sum is 280. If you subtract these two numbers, 280 minus 200 is 80. The sum of two new numbers is 80. 1x plus 4x is 5x. That will be equal to 80. 5 will be divided on the right side. 5 ones are 5. 5 6 are 30. It means x is 16. Now what is the ratio? 1:4. It is 1x and that is 4x. 16, 4 multiplied by 16, it is 64. It means first number is 16 and the second number is 64. The sum of two numbers is 64 plus 16 is 80. That will be the correct option in the exam. Whenever you have a question of ratio, you will have to suppose the numbers. If you have 1:4, the two numbers are 1x and 4x. If you have two numbers, 2:3, that will be 2x and 3x. Now question number 3. Calculate mean if question number 3, find mean x bar when n is equal to 15, summation u is equal to 150 and u is equal to x minus 75 over 4. Everyone knows the formula of mean in the coding method, a plus summation u over n multiplied by h. And dear students, we know that is actually a, and it is in the division, that is h. Just substitute the values. What is a? 75 plus summation u is 150. 150 over n is 15 multiplied by h. In the denominator, that is h. 15 ones are, 15 tens are. 75 plus 10 fours are 40, and that will be 115. 115 will be the correct option in the exam. Question number 4. The sum of deviations of 20 values, n is equal to 20, from 30, actually we have summation d, is 55. The sum of deviations of 20 values from 30 is 55. Summation d is 55, and from after from we have a, it is 30. D is equal to x minus a, d is equal to x minus 30. Find the mean x bar. We know the formula, a plus summation d over n. What is a? A is 30. 30 plus 55 over 20. 30 plus, that is 2.75, and the last answer will be 32.75. that will be the correct option in the exam. Question number 5, a very important multiple choice question for all the papers of statistics. For a frequency distribution, mean is 52.5, x bar is 52.5, median is 46. Find the approximate value of the mode by using the empirical relation. Mode you are to find, we know the formula, mode is equal to 3 into median minus 2 mean. That is the empirical relation. Just substitute the values. 3 into 46, median is 46, minus 2 into 52.5. 46, 3 is 138, minus 105, answer will be 33, will be the correct option in the exam. Question number 6. The mean wage of 6 workers is Rs. 850 per day. X bar is given, Rs. 850 for 6 workers. First of all, you will have to find summation x. X bar is equal to summation x over n. X bar is given, 850. Summation x is not given, n is given. Multiply these two and you will get 5100 for summation x. The total amount of 6 workers is 5100 per day. What is the mean wage of further 4 workers? You have to find the mean of 4 more workers if the mean wage of 10 workers is Rs. 1000. Mean of 10 workers, n is equal to 10 is given, that is 1000. First of all, find out summation x over n. X bar is given, 1000. Summation x is not given, 10 is given. 10 will be multiplied with 1000, that will be 10,000. Rupees summation x, and you have to find what is the mean wage of further more workers if the mean wage of 10 workers is given. We have to find out the mean of 4 workers, actually n is 4, summation x over n. X bar is not given, summation x of 4 workers, that is the sum of all the 10 workers per day. 10,000 minus 5100 was the sum of 6 workers, minus 5100. that is 4900. 4900 is the sum of 4 new workers divided by 4, and you will get the answer that will be 1225 rupees. A very important question for all the papers of statistics. Question number 7. The arithmetic mean, geometric mean and harmonic mean of a distribution of continuous variable were computed as 25.60, 24.27 and 23.82. Identify arithmetic mean, geometric mean and harmonic mean. Dear students, that is a very important concept of statistics. If all the values of x are same, you have 2, 2, 2, it means its x bar will be equal to 2, geometric mean will also be equal to 2, harmonic mean will also be equal to 2. If all the values of a data are same, arithmetic mean, geometric mean and harmonic mean will always be equal, but these are different values. In that case, you know the formula: arithmetic mean is always greater than geometric mean and geometric mean is always greater than harmonic mean. Which is the largest value? 25.60. It means that is the value of arithmetic mean. 24.27 is the value of geometric mean and 23.82 is the value of harmonic mean. A very important concept of statistics. Question number 8. It is also called average of position. A part median, B part quartiles, C part deciles and percentiles, D part all of the above. Dear students, please keep in mind, median, quartiles, deciles and percentiles, they all are called average of position. Number 9. Can all quartiles be expressed as percentiles? Yes. Actually, Q1 is also called P25, Q3 is called P75 and Q2 is called P50. Yes, all the three quartiles can also be expressed by percentiles. Q1 is equal to P25, Q3 is equal to P75 and Q2 is equal to P50. Question number 10. Dear students, I ask something from you. Summation x minus x bar whole square, we know it is minimum. What is the meaning of that statement? That is the property of arithmetic minimum. It means that summation x minus x bar whole square is always less than summation xi minus a whole square. A is any arbitrary value other than mean. Summation x minus x bar whole square, the value of number 11 is summation xi minus a whole square is always greater than summation xi minus x bar whole square. And number 12 is summation xi minus a whole square is equal to summation xi minus x bar whole square plus n times x bar minus a whole square. That is also very important property of arithmetic mean. And these three questions can also be asked in every paper of statistics. Summation x minus x bar whole square is always less than summation x minus a whole square. A is any value other than mean. And you can also say that summation x minus a whole square is always greater than summation x minus x bar whole square. And the third one is summation x minus a whole square is equal to summation x minus x bar whole square plus n times x bar minus a whole square. Assalamu alaikum.